there's this massive problem of air pollution and how damaging that can be to people. When lockdown happened, we went out to see the levels of exposure. We used the backpack data loggers that we developed for the Breathe London project.
Inside the backpack, we've got two sensors and a GPS module. The first sensor is a particulate sensor to detect the size and concentration of particles. Second sensor is the gas sensor. We're measuring NO2 and VOCs. What's really exciting is that this is some of the technology we use in our purifiers as well.
This has been a global campaign that I've been lucky enough to be involved with.
I am an air quality scientist.
2 weeks wearing this baby.
I've got my backpack on from Dyson, and we're doing a study to see what the air quality is like during lockdown versus post-lockdown.
As you can see, it's a gorgeous day.
On a typical Friday evening, this street looks very different.
Certainly cycling around central London felt really nice actually during lockdown.
It is kind of lovely to hear life instead of cars.
During lockdown it was a lot more peaceful. There's been less cars, less buses, less flights. We're on our way to Battersea, just realised that it's pretty loud.
Tons of construction out today.
And we're seeing a lot more cars and buses and everyone back on the road essentially.
That was my second 5K out today. Air quality felt pretty garbage. I felt like my lungs couldn't keep up with me.
Comparing the two phases, when we look at the NO2 data, we can see that there appears to have been a cleaner phase in phase one, which is the lockdown, and a worse phase in phase two, which is post-lockdown. That might be linked to more traffic and more transportation happening around the cities. PM2.5, however, we don't see a consistent difference between phase one and phase two. It's very impacted by a lot of different things. Activities that we do individually, things a bit more out of our control, like the seasons and wind direction, things like that.
We also looked at some data from our connected purifiers
so that we can start to understand the link between indoor and outdoor air quality. Overall, we saw a trend toward PM2.5 increase.
And we suspect it's because obviously people are spending more time at home, they're cooking, for example, and then if you're doing more cleaning, that potentially a couple of explanations there about why we're seeing that. But it's not an easy problem to fix, and it's not going to just go away. And so that's why this awareness and education piece is such an important part. The more information we get about it, the impact it has on people, how we can resolve some of those issues, the better position we're in, I think.